recovery from the Achilles in 2013. I left Asia playing, got a job in Australia, second league. Season was going very well. It was a blessing to actually get to play two seasons in 1 year. Season was going well. I remember like it was yesterday. I was playing the game third quarter against Gold Coast, and I took one step. The step I took popped my Achilles. When I popped my Achilles, I didn't know what Achilles was. I didn't know, you know, how it could happen. All I remember is I was getting ready to play third quarter, took one step, pop, for instance. I thought somebody hit me with a bat from behind. It was the worst injury ever. I came out the game, couldn't even walk. The doctor from the team said, what happened? I said, man, it felt like I got hit with a bat from behind. And he said, that's not good. So I'm looking at him like, what do you mean that's not good? You know, it's third quarter, you know, this game, we need the game to go to the playoffs. He said, I think that's your Achilles. And I was just like, you know, at that moment, I didn't know what it was. I didn't know how bad it could happen or what. So, you know, the next day we went to the doctor. I woke up the next morning and it was swollen. And I was like, man, you know, hopefully I can ice it, you know, take care of injuries. Went to the doctor, took an x-ray. Said it's your Achilles. I'm thinking, okay, this is probably about, you know, 2 months or, you know, 2 weeks or something like that. Now the doctor sat down with me and told me, he said, you're gonna be out for a good little minute. And I was just like, whoa. So the first thing I did, man, I called my parents. You know, me not being home for another, since September, and this is what, I think it might have been like July right now, August. I was like, Mom, you know, I tore my Achilles. They didn't know what it was either. I was like, I'm out. Like, I need to have surgery as soon as possible if I want to make a comeback. So I was down, you know, felt like somebody took basketball away from me. So we left there. My coach, you know, he was kind of down. The next day in an article in paper in Australia, import all-star goes down with Achilles injury. It didn't hit me until I read that article the next day. And so, you know, I got my flight to go back to the States. It put me in first class, so, you know, I like that. But at the same time, man, I had to leave my team. And, you know, we didn't make playoffs that year, and I was kind of devastated by that because, you know, we worked hard to get to that point, and this happened. But they always say you never question what God does. So, I mean, I was still, you know, mad about it, but so I flew home. 26-hour plane ride back to America, North Carolina. I had surgery. I went to the doctor. I showed him the x-rays that I took in Australia. And it went from there. And he told me, he said, I said, Doc, you know, let me know. What's the family doctor? I said, let me know, you know, how long it's going to be. He was like, it's going to be hard to come back in 7 months, maybe more, depending on your body. You know, with your age right now, you know, you're active, but it's going to take a while. So, you know, the first thing I did, I put my head down. And, you know, it was hard for me from that Achilles injury. And so, I had surgery. It went well. All I remember is that big boot I had for a good 6 weeks, I think. Maybe 6 weeks. Boot was big. I had crutches, I had a hard cast, I had some elevated. I remember certain nights, man, I still play that picture in my mind when it happened, and it was hard, man. If it wasn't for my girlfriend Megan, you know, sticking around with me while it happened, and my mom and my dad and my brother and his wife and some friends, I don't know how I could have made it through that. Somebody took, you know, this right here from me. And this right here has led me a lot of places in life and also getting to see other countries. And this helped me get an education for free, Division I. Imagine somebody taking something from you that you love. So, you know, I had to deal with it. So, you know, I kept dealing with it, as in, at the booth, couldn't do nothing else, couldn't play basketball anymore. So, you know, that went on. And then, you know, 6 weeks went by, you know, I'm asking the doctor, you know, every time I go for my checkup, what can, you know, how's it going? Oh, it's feeling great, you know. But, you know, doctors have to tell you, you know, certain stuff, so, you know, you'll be quiet, but, you know, it's healing great. So let's say, I'm gonna skip it through that. So we went probably after the boot. And after the boot, I had to go through two stages of heel cups. Heel cups in my shoe. I had to learn how to walk again, put pressure on my heel. So I'm like, man, this doctor, man, you know, it's about, I think it might have been about October now. I'm like, okay, maybe this is going to be a little, you know, I can rush it, you know, get back on the court. So I put the heel cup in my shoe. I remember the doctor's office. I put the heel cup in my shoe. I was like, you know, this doesn't feel right, you know. I can't put pressure on my feet. So, you know, we start walking around, and I was like, man, this is not going to work, man. This hurts. He said, after this heel cup, you got rehab. I said, okay, man. He said, but you got to listen. I said, okay. So we did that heel cup for 2 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. After we did the heel cup for 2 or 3 weeks, we changed it. We changed the heel cup to another size, where now I'm starting to put a little bit more pressure on my heel. So that worked. So I had that for another 2 or 3 weeks. So we did that, and I'm done with them stages of heel cup. So now I'm putting a shoe on, and I'm actually walking. And man, that was the most painful thing, because you gotta think about it, I haven't had a shoe on my foot for a good 3 months, 2 or 3 months. If it was a shoe, it wasn't tight, it was a flip-flop. So we went from there, and I finally, doctor said, look, all right, we can easily get into rehab. So I'm happy. It's, you know, still November now, October, November. So I went to D1 training facility. The doctor said, look, this is one of the best people to get you back from the injury. Philip Rivers is the manager of the D1 training. He created it in Durham, in Raleigh, North Carolina, where it was. I told the doctor, I remember, I said, doc, I gotta get back. I miss basketball, man. I gotta get back. So he said, all right, look, I'm gonna take care of you. We're gonna gradually get into it. So we started doing 1 or 2 days. And you saw how hungry I was in rehab. So, you know, we slowly got into it. Then around the middle time, around I think December, I started running a little bit, like a little jog. We started getting to 4 times a week. That's how bad I went. 4 times a week we were doing rehab. I mean, it was painful sometimes. I can remember after rehab, I used to sit in the car. It was hurting, but I couldn't show it in the facility that I was hurting, but I was pushing. I wanted it bad. And I remember a couple times at home, I would be at home, it'd be late at night, and I was to ask my dad, I said, Dad, let's go to my high school. I can get into my high school in Southern Durham. I can get in there anytime. So, you know, I called the assistant AD. I said, look, I want to get in the gym and shoot. So me and my dad, you know, took a little ride there. We went to the gym and started shooting. And we used to do that a couple times. And you know, just to catch up, you know, like the old times in high school. So me and my dad shooting, you know, putting shots up, but I couldn't run. I still couldn't elevate off of the shot, but I felt like because I can shoot now, I want to be in the gym. So I started putting a lot of shots up, standing still, a lot of shots. So we started going. And then the doctor said, look, now we can add running. Now we're going to the turf field. So we're on the turf field. I'm really getting into it now. I'm starting to quick feet on the ladder, you know, jumping. So the doctor said, look, I can get you back probably by March. And I was like, let's go. We started getting intense with it. We started going hard. I think I might have picked up 5 days a week now. So we're going hard. 2 hours, we always went 2 hours, 5 hours in there. I mean, 5 times a week, 2 hours. Going hard in rehab, running, jogging. Finally got back. Started playing pickup in there. Now you gotta imagine, I haven't played pickup in about 5 months, 6 months now. So I started playing pickup basketball. I was hesitant. Scared to make a step, I was scared to make a move because I didn't trust my leg yet. You gotta think about it. The Achilles in this leg, I lost a lot of muscles because of that. So I was always going off this leg too much. And they always said, you injure one side of your Achilles, most likely the other side's gonna happen because you're applying too much pressure. So I started pickup. Pickup started going good, but because I was always in the gym shooting, my shots started getting a lot better. So I start shooting, you know, I start putting shots up. So my agent that I had at that moment, at that time. You know, he was always asking me every 2 weeks, hey, how's your recovery going? How's things going? I said, it's going good. And he said, look, you know when you was in Australia, don't look back. And I said, yeah, you're right, but you gotta think about it. You got me a job in Bulgaria as soon as I left Australia. I said, that's the only thing I think about now. Is I had a job in Europe in Bulgaria as soon as I left Australia. And then this happened a week later. And I said, he stopped me and said, hey, you know, I told you, don't look back. And I took that where he said, I didn't look back anymore. So I started pushing myself, started going twice harder. I started going to Duke University in Durham, North Carolina. And I started running steps every Saturday to show how committed I was. I used to have my young little guy that I trained sometime. He looks up to me, Mel. And we used to go out there and train. And I used to run the steps every Saturday, up and down in the football stadium. A lot of people do that in Durham, at Duke. So I started doing that just to get my steps right, my agility right. So then my agent said, look, I got something in Italy that might can help you. Are you back yet? And I said, hey, give me about another 2 or 3 weeks. I think I can do it. So, you know, I told him, I got back to him. I felt like I was ready. So I went to Italy. I went to Gorizia, Italy. And it was a good experience. I was able to get back on the court. I was able to actually be in action again. I was happy. Still hesitant about certain moves, but I was happy. I felt like God gave me another chance. They say a lot of people don't recover back from this Achilles injury. I could have put my head down. I could have stopped. I could have gave up. But I wasn't ready. I felt like my journey hasn't ended yet. So went to Italy. I did real well. You know, I caught a little eyes. People said, what happened? I said, I had to take this year off because of my Achilles injury. So, you know, that's all I can say. I had no film. Only thing I had was from Australia. So they said, look, man, you did real good in Australia, man. You was averaging 15 before this. You know, what happened? I told him Achilles. That was it. I said, after that, I don't want to talk about it. I said, right now, I'm just trying to, you know, get back. So Italy happened. Great, great thing. Great, you know, great everything, actually. Did real good. Met a lot of people, connections. So then I went back home. Went back to the States. I started working out again harder. Like, I knew I needed to work on when I left Italy. So around August or September, I met this guy in Romania, you know, through my agent. It was a deal that I thought that was pretty good. So, you know, I was ready. Two weeks later, two sponsors backed out. So I was like, oh, snap, man. What am I gonna do? I'm supposed to be in Romania playing. So I called my agent, called a friend. Hey, man, I wanna come back to Singapore. You know, can you make that happen? So, you know, called the team, went from there. So now, back in Asia. Great season, great team. Nothing more I can say about it. It's great everything. The fans were happy to see me back. I was happy to see myself back. I owe it all to God. I was just happy. I was glad I was back. You know, people say you cannot come back from Achilles, and it's hard. I proved myself and to people. People back home, people elsewhere, like, man, you gonna be back though? You gonna be the same person or what? It's like, man, I worked hard, but I'm ready. So I came back, season started. Man, we started playing real well. This year we had 3 imports. Rest, you know, rest were good, definitely good. Helped us out a lot. So we're playing, you know, ups and downs, like always season. But, you know, it's life. So we had a great season this year. But we had one little problem. March 3rd, 2015. I remember like it was yesterday too. I woke up, like always in the morning time, I read my Jesus calling book. Before I read my Jesus calling book, I walked upstairs, and you know, like always, my Wi-Fi always go out, so you know, I went upstairs, and I cut my phone off, and my phone cut on, and I had a message from my brother, said, call home, so I'm thinking, you know, it's probably my little niece, want to see me on FaceTime or something, so I call home, I say, yo, what's up, Kels? His name is Kelly, I call him Kels. And he said, Brahma. I said, what you mean? And he said, grandma passed away in her sleep. My head dropped. I was lost for words. It was hard for me at that moment to realize. I went home for Christmas. Coach gave us 2 weeks to go home. I'm glad I went home for 2 weeks. I got to see my grandma. She was suffering from Alzheimer's disease. I got to see her, spend some time with her. That was my best friend. And I booked the ticket March 3rd that night. Went home. It was the longest flight to me ever. I went home for 5 days, 57 hours in 5 days. I went home, you know, coach allowed me to go home and the general manager allowed me to go home. It was hard. I mean, my grandma, and, you know, me and her were very close, very close. I looked up to her. And I'm glad I went home for Christmas, but I always told her before I went back overseas, you know, stay strong, I'll be back. And my mom always sent me pictures, you know, during the season. And she goes to see her at the rest home, and that's what I remember. You know, every week I get pictures from my grandma, seeing how she was, you know, how she's doing. And they said, my mom told me, she said the last word she said that morning was to the lady in the rest home, that my grandson scored 20 points in the game before. And it was hard for me, man. I got home after that 57 hours. And the first thing I did when my dad came up from the airport, and he knew I was, you know, down, you know, he tried to talk to me and stuff. So we get home and my mom's home. And the first thing when I saw my mom come, when I went through the door, I just hugged her because I felt for her. You know, my mom did everything possible to help my grandma. Sorry, man, it's kind of emotional, but like, she did everything possible to help my grandma. And only thing that I could do was just hug my mom. So all I could do was hug my mom. So, you know, we talked. And at that time, my girlfriend, she was still in Atlanta before she went back to Spain. So she came down. I was, you know, I'm glad she came down to, you know, spend time with me and help me get through this moment or whatnot. So we went through that. That was the hardest moment ever. I wanted to give up basketball. I just wanted to stop. So my mom said, and my dad and my brother, like, don't give up. She wouldn't want you to give up. So I didn't give up. So I came back and I told myself, I'm gonna dedicate this season to her. So I dedicated the season to her, and I put everything on the line when I came back. I worked even harder in practice. I spent more time in the gym. I knew she was watching over me. So I might have told the other imports, I was like, look, I want to win this for her, man. Like, let's take care of business. Like, let's go. So we did it, man. We stuck together. We bonded like we always did. They could see how hungry I was. I was determined to win this for my grandma. Made it to the championship game. I was happy, man. I was like, we made it, man. We did it. Each round, we took care of business. Championship game came down to it. Packed crowd, hot, loud. Free throws came down to it. 78-78. I remember going to the line. They had their fans, we had our fans. They were booing me at the free throw line. 78-78. I looked up and said, Grandma, this is for you. And knocked down both free throws at crucial time periods. And that was probably the best moment of my life, to make those free throws before I said it for my grandma. And we won. We won the championship. And the first thing I did when the buzzer went off, I just pointed to the sky and said, you know, Grandma, that was for you. And like, I was happy, man. It was just like, I did it. Like, I did it. And it came a long way from Achilles a year ago. to a championship that I won. And I remember calling my mom and dad after the game, like, "Mom, Dad, we did it. Like, I did it. Like, you know, I did it. I came back from Achilles injury, and people said that I wouldn't even probably come back or be the same. You know, this season I ended up averaging 16.1 points per game, 3-point-something rebounds, 3-point-something assists. Like, I did it. I could have went back to Australia, but I had to make a choice. Like, I did it, and I feel good about myself. And I look back through all my photos in my phone, talking to my girl Meg at the time, and I'm like, I came a long way from Achilles injury that I used to have a limp. Now, don't get me wrong, you know, when I first wake up in the morning, I have a limp, you know, on my walk, but I'm fine. And I'm thankful that God gave me another opportunity. And it was about my family and my girlfriend and friends that helped me get through it and pushed me through it. I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful. I'm glad I was able to come back from this. When people say that you can't do nothing, or you think in yourself that you can't do it, just ask God. God will help you get through that. God opened doors for people. When he know that you don't have any confidence, it's all confidence, basically. It's all knowing what you want to do with your life. And I told myself I wasn't ready to be done with basketball. I wasn't. And, you know, I'm glad, I'm thankful for this team, the Falcons. I'm thankful for them giving me an opportunity. And one of the sponsors for us, Tumor, I just want to say thank you, man. He has a daughter that's amazing. Get to training sometime. Amazing. And I just want to thank you for that, too. For all you've done. He's a sponsor for our team, man. Thank you. I want to give a special thank you to, man, Asia, for, you know, allowing me to come back. Allowing me to play here again. Allowing me to just walk around and smile like always. And all I can say is, people out there that, you know, if you have an injury or somebody say that you can't do anything, just turn your head and walk away. Because deep down inside, you're the only person that can do it. Nobody else can do it for you. Only yourself. And so, hopefully, you know, this year with the film I have and what I did, hopefully I can get another job somewhere else. Or come back here, maybe. But it's never going to be easy. You really got to work. I could have gave up. I did not give up. I kept fighting. And now I'm finishing my 7-year plan. That's a blessing. Some people didn't even think I could make it. I proved people wrong. Not just people, but myself. And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for a lot. And at the end of the day, I know my grandma's still watching now. Like always. That's just a blessing to actually have a guardian angel to look down on me every day, every time. Just thankful for that. So, when somebody say that you can't do it, or you're not capable, or, man, you got an injury, man, you won't be the same. Just turn your cheek and walk away. That's it. So, this game right here that came back, I'm thankful for it. Thank you.